Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Swapna here. Hope you all are staying safe and staying creative. So today I've come up with a beautiful tropical design to be painted on perspex. Just like peacocks, I've always had an inclination towards this beautiful macaw birds, and this tropical flowers and leaves in the background makes it even more prettier. So here I've drawn the design on a paper, and this is a perspex that I'll be using to paint. You can feel free to paint on glass as well, and this is the palette that I'll be using today. So basically we have shades of yellow, orange, red, green and blue. According to the availability of glass paints here, I keep collecting the favorite shades of mine from whichever brand available. Today I am trying out yet another different technique to paint on this glass or perspex. So unlike earlier times, I am not using the glass liner at first. I've right away started painting using a brush, and this is just like any other watercolor painting or acrylic painting. So you can notice how easily the paint is flowing, and I'm using various shades like red, yellow, blue and green to paint on this macaw first. Since I've kept the background design intact, it's easier for me to apply the paint in the right positions. Also, I'm using all the solvent-based glass colors, and it's easier for me to spread the paints evenly with the small brush. Make sure to clean the bristles of the brush before using each shade. I mostly use Odorless White Spirit to clean my brushes whenever I'm using this glass paints or any other solvent based paints. Now I've almost completed the painting part, and this is how it looks without the pattern on the background. And the next step is to add all the details using the glass liners. I'm basically using these three shades of Pebeo Sun Relief glass liners, that is black, silver and golden. You can use any branded glass liners or 3D liners according to the availability at your place. Also, at this stage, you can feel free to add any freehand designs or doodles to decorate or create texture on this painting. So the detailing part is also finished, and this is how it looks. So the next step is to make this painted part opaque. For this, I'm taking the reverse part of the perspex, and throughout the painted portion, I'm adding white acrylic paint. I'm just dabbing the paint. Since most of our glass paints are transparent, Adding this white acrylic paint on the reverse side of the perspex or the glass will help us achieve an opaque effect. After applying the white acrylic paint on the background and let it dry thoroughly, and we'll receive a beautiful opaque painting on the perspex like this. Now I wanted yet another complementing texture to go in the background, and for that I'm using this burlap. I've cut out a small rectangular portion of this burlap cloth from the roll, and this is how I'll place it on the background of the perspex. So I'm using a small A5 size ready-made frame, and while framing on the reverse side of the perspex, I'll keep the burlap cloth and frame it like this. If you're giving the framing to be framed outside or to a framer, just let them know about your requirement to keep this burlap cloth in the middle of the painting. And as a finishing touch, I'm adding few more dots using golden and silver liner. And this is how our finished painting is looking. Hope you all enjoyed watching this new and interesting glass painting technique. If you liked this video and felt it's informative, please don't forget to like, comment and share this video, and please consider subscribing the channel for more interesting videos. Thank you for watching.